Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's talk about quick ways to get to your display preferences in Mountain Lion. Now, one of the changes that came with Mountain Lion was the removal of the little menu bar icon in the upper right that allowed you to quickly access your display preferences. You could change the resolution of your display, you can set mirroring on and off, things like that. We don't have that anymore, but it's still pretty easy to get to your display preferences if you need to. So the typical way to get to your display preferences is to go to the Apple menu and go to System Preferences, and then from there click on Displays. Now, that's a lot of steps, so it'd be nice to have a shortcut. And in fact, there is a keyboard shortcut to get there. Now, if you notice on your Apple keyboard at the top where you have the function keys, you've got special functions they can perform. For instance, the volume key is usually around F10, F11, control volume going up and down. F1 and F2 are brightness controls, which are display controls. Now, the cool thing is that if you use the option key with one of these, you can get directly to the system preferences that match whatever the function is. So for instance, if you wanted to get to your sound system preferences, you could do option and then the volume up or volume down or mute keys at the top of your keyboard. Likewise, you can have option and the F1 or F2, which are brightness, and instantly go to the system preferences for the display. Now, if you've got things toggled so those keys are actually F keys, F1, F2, rather than the brightness control keys, then you need to hit the FN key on your keyboard. There's an FN key. Sometimes it's the bottom left. Sometimes it's near the upper right. Hold that down, then hold down Option, and then hit one of the two brightness control keys at the top, and that will instantly launch System Preferences and go right to Displays. Really quick. It's the quickest way to get there. Now, you may already have System Preferences here at the bottom in the dock. If you don't, it's easy to get it there. You go to System Preferences and then you see that it appears on the right side of the dock. Drag it from the right side over to the left side anywhere you want, and now when you quit System Preferences, it will stay there. Now you can access it quickly by clicking on it and it goes to System Preferences, but if you control click on it, you actually get a list of all your System Preferences and you can quickly access Displays that way. Here's something else you can do. You can use Automator or the Apple Script Editor to create a simple Apple script. Using Automator, I use the Run Apple Script command here, dragged it over to this side, and I added this to the middle of it. Basically, tell application system preferences to activate, set the current pane to pane:\apple.preference.displays. And tell. So you can see the complete script right there. It's pretty easy. I created this as an application and now I can save it, and I'm just going to save it to my desktop here, and I've got it here as this just test.app. I'll quit Automator, and when I run test.app you see that it actually will launch that preference pane. I can now add this to the dock if I wanted to, and I have an instant way to get there. Now, you may have noticed that I have up here a menu icon that looks like it might be the Displays menu, and in fact it is. The way I've got this is I haven't brought it back from Line or anything like that. I've just added a third-party app that adds this icon here and all sorts of controls for your displays. You can see I've got two displays. I can set them. I can turn mirroring on and off. I can use detect displays just like you could before Mountain Lion. So how did I get this? Well, it's pretty easy. Just go to the Mac App Store. It's called Display Menu. It's free, and I'm sure there are other ones that do this as well. This is just the first one I came across some time ago, and I've been using it ever since. So one final tip. If you do go to System Preferences and go to Displays, one thing that we had before that was very useful, especially if you're somebody that made presentations all the time and was using all sorts of different projectors and displays hooked up to your MacBook, say, was a Detect Displays button. This was helpful when you had, say, an old projector that just, for some reason, you hook it up to your Mac and it didn't recognize it right away. So you had to sometimes disconnect and reconnect or hit the very handy Detect Displays button. And you could see, well, it's not there. Well, actually it is. If I hold the Option key down, you could see I'm holding Option key down here and the Gather Windows button changes to Detect Display. So you still have that button there that's very handy for sort of jump starting a presentation hooked up to a projector. You still have that. You just got to remember to hit the Option key. So the reason the display menu icon isn't there anymore is for most Mac users. If you're using an iMac, if you're using a MacBook, you don't need to mess with the displays. You're only ever using your main display. That's probably 90% of all Mac users. But if you're somebody that gives a lot of presentations or you have a monitor at your desk or someplace you usually go to that you sometimes connect to, it can be handy to have quick access to this so you can check or set your display settings. So I hope you found this useful. Until next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.